some COVID-related cancellations, both against Syracuse. They won at Syracuse, had a couple of games postponed, and then won at home against Syracuse to go to 3-1 on the league. A nice save there by Stewart, but into the hands of the Panthers. And Tony will draw, takes care of itself.
Well, that makes me think, too, about some of the young guys you see on the floor. That's one of the things they don't understand. They don't understand the effort given at this level. The sense of urgency on every single cut, every single pass, defensive rotation.
Capel yesterday, and we asked him, hey, that win over Syracuse, I mean, they scored 64 points in the second half. They won. It felt like they got every 50-50 ball to Champagne into the game. In Pittsburgh, Duke is 5-3 on the season. The three losses at home to Michigan State, at home to Illinois, at Virginia Tech. They are 3-1 in the league, but the three wins have come against the three bottom teams in the...
Make drives, find the open man. That's when they're going to start to develop and really develop a feel for this game at this level.
Champagne, his second three of the game already, came in shooting just 25%. Matthew Hurt, who's a terrific three-point shooter, misses that one. 44% on the season. Xavier Johnson somehow completed the play and give him an assist. Louisville.
Yeah.
Virginia's on top right now. Sam Hauser got to at least be in the conversation. And Florida State looking really good. MJ Walker, a terrific player for them. And you know,
we're going to see that again sometime. I just hope it's really late. Maybe April.
It would be, yeah, it would be really late. It would be in April. It wouldn't even be in March if they were to meet. DJ Stewart, the freshman from Chicago, with a three to tie it. And then guess who is, because of COVID protocols, Pitt both within and beyond their program, Duke just outside of their program.
I think in terms of games played and how we value that, in terms of the development of a team, how far along, talk about that enough, where it's not just the games that these guys are missing, it's time on the floor, time in the locker room, opportunity to develop that dynamic. It's just not there.
Pitt on a 7-0 run right now, up by 5, 2.5 to go in the first half at the Peterson Event Center. Good ball movement. Tony, wide open, misses the three. You told me every shot you missed was a feel-good miss. You were ready to take
Absolutely.
Another one as soon as you got it back.
Absolutely.
And looks like that. Champagne for three. What a half. 17 points now. And so again, a guy back early off a knee injury. Never looked like he missed a beat. 24-16 against Syracuse on Saturday in his return. 17-10 at halftime in this game. That 15-point deficit down to 8. And maybe we're seeing things, but there appears to be a little bit more energy in that zone right now, and they get a shot clock violation.
Six. For a lot of us, we watch Synergy. Synergy would tell you the same thing. Duke has a good adjustment out of timeouts, and they're usually successful.
Champagne with a block on Johnson. Joey Baker inside. He has it rejected, and it's off his finger. A little pressure here. And Odekali gets it over for Pitt. But Duke has definitely stepped up the intensity at the defensive end.
Because this young Duke team has responded.
Nice drive and kick. Nice shot fake. Boy, they're doing everything right and eventually get rewarded.
Not a chance. Look, no. Maybe in a previous life I was a bare-knuckle fighter, but not in this one. I'm a little softer in this life. Defense taking away that high post area, but pressuring the ball much better, not allowing Pitt to pick out their passes. God, that was a lot of peas, wasn't it?
Champagne, 16-footer.
We're gonna have to keep an eye on that when he comes back in. If he comes back in,
Duke turns it over. Xavier Johnson, a three-year starter, back to Champagne.
Jeez.
His fourth three of the game. He's up to 28 points on the night. It's their time now to respond because momentum continues to shift in the Blue Devils' favor. And had that shot gone down, it would have been a two-point game.
Than you do in a man. You can't cheat at all in a zone.
Pitt has not made a field goal in 6 minutes. Until now, and who else? Champagnie, who's now got